Hello everyone. We are from Annamacharya Institute of Technology and Sciences from Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. These are our project members and we are doing this project under the guidance of M. Ravikishore sir, Assistant Professor in the Department of ECE. So these are the contents we are going to present in this presentation. So the objective of our project is implementing a low power multiplexer. Either it is mainly we are doing project on 2x1 multiplexer using QCA technology, which replaces the present CMOS technology. By replacing the present CMOS technology, we are designing a 2x1 multiplexer using QCA technology. So for the long time, many researchers, developers are working to develop a nanoscale circuit, nanoscale electronic circuits with high performance and with low power consumption. So for that, QCA is one of the nanotechnologies used to design circuits with high speed and with low power consumption. So QCA, what is QCA? QCA is nothing but quantum dot cellular automata. The full form of this, quantum dot cellular automata. When we see the structure of that QCA, it is a shape like square having four dots, both are connected with, all are connected with tunnel junctions. So and also inside the dots we are having electrons. So the entire design is we call QCA cell, one cell. So we are having two types of cells, either it is a logic 0 or logic 1. How we are going to define whether it is logic 0, logic 1 means based on the placing of electrons. So here the in figure, the electrons are paired diagonally. So it is placed in first and third, electrons are placed in first and third position. So it is logic 0. If the electrons are placed in second and fourth position, it is logic 1. Why means if the electrons are placed in straight due to Coulombic reflection between two electrons, electrons moves away together. So that's why the initial electrons are placed in diagonal manner. So based on that cell, we are developing two major gates are developed, that is QCA inverter gate and majority gate. So mostly by using these logics or logic of these gates, we are implementing multiplexer circuit. So existing technology. So present multiplexers are designed by using CMOS logics. Here when you see that in the diagram, it is having with PMOS and NMOS. We know that CMOS is nothing but the combination of PMOS and NMOS. You see that the upper part of the diagram is nothing but PMOS, the down part is nothing but NMOS. It is also called as pull up network and pull down network. So how we design this transistor based on the means, you know that multiplexer is circuit which takes several inputs and gives single output. So based on the boolean function of the multiplexer, we are going to design the circuit. So you see that for 2x1 multiplexer, it is having two inputs and one output and one selection line. So if the selection line is zero, the first input will be taken as first will be output. If the selection line will be one, the output will be second input. So like that, we are multiplexer circuit we are having. So in between the PMOS and NMOS, we are placing the output. So our inverted, we are getting inverted output, nothing but CMOS output which we want. So this is the design of existing CMOS technology. So in this present, in the olden days, the CMOS technology having lot of drawbacks. It consumes high power and it takes large area. It is the transistors are very large area and these transistors occupies more space. So and it due to that more space, the speed of the circuit is also very low. At power consumption, we are using so many transistors. That's why power consumption also very high. So for that, for the overcome of these disadvantages, we are going to QCA technology. As we discussed earlier, QCA technologies have a QCA basics and QCA basic cell. So here the in the diagram you are seeing QCA based 2 by 1 multiplexer. It is the proposing technology which overcome the previous drawbacks of previous technology. So you are seeing that having different colors, blue, green cells. Why these different colors means those colors are having they are representing the different types of. So blue color is inputting the inputs, green color inputs in the data transformation. So yellow is the output. So for the difference of the different parameters, so we are using different colors. So we know that QCSL we are developing two basic. We are developed two basic gates. One is inverter gate and majority gate. Based on the logic of this, we know that inverter gate. If the inverter gate is one input one and output zero. If the majority gate also, if the majority of the cells having same logic, the output also same logics. So based on those logics, we are implementing the circuit. So we have see that if the input is high, if the cell is placed in if there no Coulombic reflection, the same logic will transfer to the next cell. Like that, the data will be transmitted to the next cell. So if there is a Coulombic reflection between electrons, the electrons change its logics. So if the logic 0 means it is having polarization minus 1, logic 1 means polarization having plus 1. So by using those basic gates, inverter gate and majority gate logic, we are implementing this. We are implementing multiplexer. So these are the simulation results we are getting when we design the circuit. So you see that we are having first two inputs and one selection line and one output. So you see that if the input is zero, when we get the output first input select. This is nothing but if the selection line is 0, we are taking the output as first input. If the selection line is 1, we are taking the first input as second input. So we are taking the output as second input. So that based on that is that means if the selection line is 0, that you get input A. Selection line is B1, that you get input B. So we are having different clock zones, different clocks, that is a clock 0, clock 1. So by using these different clocks, we are going to get the better efficiency for the circuit. So we know that in QCA technology, we are having four clock phases. Switching, switch, hold, release, and relax. These are the four clock phases in QCA technology. So according to clock phases, we are these simulation results. So by observing that different clock zones, we are getting better results. So when we see that in the tabular column, we are going to compare the design. So we are designing QCA technology for the overcome the drawbacks in CMOS technology. So for that efficiency, the main aim to develop multiplex and QCA technology means energy efficiency. For efficiency, we see that if you are using 13 cells, efficiency is 1.20. If they are using 23 cells, it is efficiency is 2.073 millivolts. So like that, we are having different. If you are using less cells, the efficiency also less. So that's why based on the cells we are using to design we get the respective efficiency. So we are designing this tool on. So every design we are going to having one software tool. So we are for designing of this QCA 2 by 1 multiplexer. So we are using QCA designer tool 2.0.3. by using this designer tool, we are going to design the multiplexer on QCA technology. So for getting the advantages of this QCA technology is that low power consumption. So in CMOS technology, it is for transistors having high power consumption due to having more transistors we are using. That's why having high power consumption, and also the space also less area, because these quantum dots and the cells are having less area compared to transistors. So we it takes less space compared to CMOS logic. It also speed of the circuit also increases compared to CMOS technology, highly scalable. So these are the advantages we are, and energy efficiency also high compared to CMOS technology. These are the advantages we are having. So by conclusion, so all this project when we are doing this project because of to design a low power multiplexer with high efficiency and energy efficient multiplexer. So for that we are using QCA technology. In CMOS technology they are having some drawbacks and with regarding to power consumption and efficiency. That's why we are going to QCA technology to design multiplexer with energy efficiency. So these are the references. Thank you.